बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम जी, इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी आर सपोज टू डिस्कस ऑन वन ऑफ द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट एस्पेक्ट ऑफ ह्यूमन रिसोर्स मैनेजमेंट सब्जेक्ट, वेदर यू आर अ स्टूडेंट ऑफ एचआर एट इट्स इंट्रो लेवल, द बेसिक लेवल, और यू आर गोइंग थ्रू द रिसर्च लेवल सब्जेक्ट इन ह्यूमन रिसोर्स मैनेजमेंट और द रिसर्च इन ह्यूमन रिसोर्स मैनेजमेंट. द subject of HR planning and recruitment is always there. It is one of the most important topics which are covered by the HR managers. So in this video, I will introduce about HR planning and recruitment process. I would like to debate in detail about various concepts which we are going to study in the forthcoming videos. So without casting any delay, let's start our today's lecture. Here you can see we are given with the agenda for our presentation for this video and the next video. The strategic role of HR, what is the role of human resource planning for the long-term achievement or for the long-term success of your corporation or your company. Approaches used to forecast future human resource supply, how much supply of the labor or the employees we are expected to have in the near future. This is the second aspect we will discuss. Approaches used to forecast demand. We will study about the demand forecasting, various types and various techniques, how we can forecast our demand, or how we can fill up the gaps between the shortage of demand or surplus of demand. There will be various concepts we will be discussing in the coming videos. Then, best approaches for responding to imbalances in HR supply and demand. Then the next agenda point is steps in recruitment process, and there we will study in detail about the recruitment, also recruitment inside and outside the organization. Then evaluating efficiency and effectiveness of recruitment method. Comparative study of various recruitment methods will be done in this discussion. And then the last point is strategy for recruiting diverse workforce. So diverse workforce means we will be highlighting the examples of some multinational companies here, their strategies for recruiting employees. Okay. HR planning, it leads to the recruitment and then the selections come. As we know, in planning, we are supposed to forecast, you know, about the need of the employees and determine, you know, about the oversupply or the shortage of employees in both cases, which leads to the recruitment is the next step. Recruitment, what is recruitment? Basically locating and encouraging applicants to apply when a shortage of labor exists. So there is an opening. We actually, you know, recruitment means an opening or attracting the pool of, you know, qualified candidates to fill up the existing gap. Then the last stage comes selection, stage number three. You know, in selection, we or you as an HR manager, you have to choose the individual who have relevant qualification to the required opening or the required job vacancies. Then HR planning, in HR planning, you have to make sure you have the right people at the right time doing the right things for your organization. Basically, this is the HR mantra. These three R's: the right time, right people working at right time, and doing the right things. Strategic planning, basically your strategic direction of your business, the long-term directions. Normally it is done for 5 to 10 years of your company's goal. So you have to make strategic planning by keeping in view the human resource requirement in case of surplus or shortage. You have to consider the both cases while making strategic planning of your organization. Environmental scanning is also very important. You have to go for and look at the external forces which can or which have the anticipated impact on the number and types of jobs. Like there are various factors which, for example, you can consider the example of Corona. On one side, it has given a great downsizing and reduction in the employment. However, it has opened up new avenues for new types of jobs as well. So environmental scanning, you have to scan the external environment. You have to go for the gap analysis. Gap analysis means the difference between the required and the actual situation. For example, you are taking 5 marks out of 10. The difference of 5 actually, the gap. The required maybe should be 8 or 9 at your end. So the gap analysis, SWOT analysis, PEST or PESTREN analysis, like strengths, weaknesses, opportunities, and threats. In the coming lecture, I will discuss about those SWOT or PEST and PESTREN analysis in detail. Because at this stage, I am just giving you a bird's eye view regarding the HR planning. Then the forecasting about supply, forecasting about, you know, demand, forecast supply of employees. Do we have the right number and right types of employees? Internal supply, skills, inventories, succession plans, and external supplies, economy, labor market, occupational market. Like internally, we have forecasting supply mean, do we have right number and right types of employees working for us? Internally, supply says skills are inventories and succession plans, and external supply, like the economy, supply of employees, we get it from economy or from the labor market or from the occupational markets. A good economy normally gives a good supply of employees. So internal supply, skill inventories means the skills which are generated in the junior employees, they will actually fulfill the supply requirement of human resource. In the same way, forecasting demand, what numbers and types of employees do we need now in contemporary time as well as in the future? There should be the consideration regarding projected turnover, what can be the expected turnover, or quality and nature of current staff, new or upgrading products and services, planned change in technology or in administration, or, you know, what can be the expected budget if I add, for example, in case of a school, if I, you know, hire 5 new teachers for my school, what can be the changes or the modifications in the budget of my human resource, definitely will increase. Or in case of downsizing, it will go contrary. So you have to analyze the both cases. Gap analysis means, like I just gave you a bird eye view earlier as well. Gap analysis, staffing table, comparing between the required target as well as the actual position, the employees we have now and what we need in the future. How a school board determines how many teachers it needs this year and for the next 5 years. Actually, we are talking about the imbalances about demand and supply. In the next slides, this is the last one slide. I will have to complete my video here. But in the next video, I will be having a debate about this on this question. So imbalances in the supply and chains put processes in balance in proper place to balance supply and demand. If the school board has too many teachers this year, what should they do? The labor is surplus. If the school board does not have enough teachers this year, what should they do? It is the situation of labor shortage. Definitely they will have to hire more labor. And what can be the case in the former statement? They will have to downsize, or they will have to send on sabbaticals to few of their employees. Sabbatical means when employees go on paid leave. Anyhow, I would like to end my video here. In the coming video, I will discuss in detail about various other concepts and about the HR planning in detail. So that's all for this video. Thank you.